Hello everybody, it's Sara. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I am coming at you with a video that I am so excited about, and I am so excited that I am finally done doing everything that needed to be done in order for me to present to you my bookshelves transformation. So this is a project that I've been working on for I think almost the entirety of October, and I am so happy with how my new bookshelves turned out, and I cannot wait to take you through the entire process of creating them, putting them together, organizing everything in them. So without any further ado, let's start with the first step, and that is that I wanted to talk to you about my thought process for the transformation. So when I moved out of my parents' house and into this apartment last year, I already knew that the bookshelves that I had then were kind of like a temporary situation, because I had these bookshelves for so long. If you've been following me here since the beginning of my channel, then you would know that these bookshelves have always been around. So I already felt like I needed a change, and also one of them was slowly falling apart. Like, all of the shelves in the bookcase were starting to curve, and it was just not doing too great. Also, I wasn't a big fan of the dark wood aesthetic of these bookshelves, and they were actually not of the same height, which always annoyed me because I am a perfectionist and I love clean, straight lines, and these bookshelves were just not doing that for me. So then I had to decide on a new model of bookshelves that I wanted to get. And for a very, very long time, I thought that I wanted to get the white Billy bookshelves that a lot of people have here on BookTube. And I've always really loved the look of them because they're white, so they look very beautiful in the background, they look very light, and they always look very neat. And so for a very, very long time, that was actually the option that I wanted to go with. But then I started to think about the fact that I wanted to put plants in my bookshelves as well. And if you don't know, like, in case you don't know, putting plants in a bookcase which is closed on like three sides is not necessarily the best option, depending on where the light is hitting the bookshelves, because then your plant might not get as much light as it needs. And I've definitely seen a lot of people who put plants into their Billy bookshelves and their plants are doing fine, they're thriving, but because of the way that my apartment is made, I don't get a lot of light into this room, which is my kind of like living room slash bedroom situation. So I didn't want to have my plants in my bookshelves and then have them die, and I also did not want to get like a bunch of fake plants, because I just love real plants, I love to take care of them, they're my babies. So I wasn't too certain about the Billy bookshelves anymore, not only because of that, but also because I was thinking like maybe like a light wood situation would be interesting, like maybe it would be pretty. I also have like a lot of wood furniture in this room, so I feel like it would fit better with the whole aesthetic. Not that I'm like very, very good at aesthetics, mind you, or interior decor, like I know absolutely nothing. I feel like my space is very, very often just a combination of all of these random pieces. They don't necessarily fit together, but you know, I was trying. So then I thought maybe I could do like shelves attached to the wall. Maybe that would be a good solution, because then I could have plants, because it would be open, and I thought it would look very, very beautiful, and I could put them like at the heights that I wanted, and it could be very, very cool. But this is a rental, so it would have been a nightmare to get them out of the wall once I move out of this apartment eventually. So, you know, I decided to save future me this problem. So I started to look at other models of bookshelves online, and I specifically looked for those kinds of bookshelves that are very open, meaning that they don't have like a back, like you can see the wall through them is what I mean. But I quickly realized that these bookshelves are so expensive. I don't know why, but they were always more pricey than, say, for instance, like the Billy bookshelves at IKEA. I mean, IKEA is known to have pretty good prices, but even so, like, I would look at any other store that had the kind of bookshelves that I wanted, and I was just shocked at how expensive they could get. And I knew I wanted like two bookshelves. I have a growing book collection, I need enough room to grow and everything. So it would have been so expensive to get two of these very like fancy, beautiful bookshelves that I loved. So in an act of desperation, I went back to the IKEA website to look again at the Billy bookshelves, and then I realized that they have another model that looked similar to the bookshelves that I actually wanted. It is called the Edvard model, and the reason why I hadn't really looked into it before is because this is unfinished wood. So it kind of looks like the kind of shelves that you would put in a pantry or in a garage or in an office, but not really like for books. But I still really enjoyed the fact that they were open and that they were made out of wood, so I started to do some research to see how I could make them look better and fit more with my space and what I wanted to do with them. I've also definitely been inspired by Ariel Bissette and all of the renovation videos that she's been doing in her house. And a couple of months ago, she actually built these bookshelves herself and she stained them, and they are the kind of bookshelves that are attached to the wall, which I knew I couldn't do in my apartment. But the entire process looked not as daunting as I thought it was going to be, so I knew that if I got the Edvard IKEA bookshelves, I could maybe stain them so that they would look more the way that I wanted them to. So I looked into that and I found this picture. And I really, really loved the look of that, so I knew then that I was onto something. And this is where the makeover truly begins. So I'm going to send you over to past Sara, who has just gotten the new bookshelves and is about to start prepping them and making them beautiful and just the way that she wants them. So let's go back in time, and I will see you again at the end of the transformation process. Hello everybody, and welcome to day one of the bookshelf transformation process. So this morning I started by emptying all of my old bookshelves. I took out all of the books, put all of them on the couch, and then I removed the bookshelves from the wall so that I would have as much room as possible down here, because I have a little bit of work to do today. First thing that I have to do is to sand down all of the pieces of the new bookshelves, because they're not finished, so I'm going to sand them and then stain them. So I need to do that today. I need to start this entire process here in my living room. So this is what I'm going to be doing for the rest of the afternoon. And yeah, first step is sanding them, which should not be that complicated, but I think it will be time consuming, so I'm going to start now. It's like around 1 in the afternoon. It's also the weekend of Comic-Con and I'm having such FOMO, so I'm really happy that I have that to occupy my mind today. So yeah, I'm gonna do that, watch some videos while I'm doing it, and once I am done, I'm going to come back with another update. So enjoy the B-roll of me sending down my future bookshelves. It is time for the staining. Now, I am terrified of this part because I have never done this in my entire life. I have my stain here, so I'm going to open this, mix it well, not shake the can, just mix it in the pot, and then I have my little sponge and my little wipey thingy, and we're gonna hope for the best. We're gonna hope that I like the color and that it doesn't end up into a completely streaky mess. But if it does, or if I don't like the color, you know, I can just paint over it. So no panic, I can always just sand it and start over. That would be very annoying, but you know, it would be better than just completely ruining all of those pieces of wood. So yeah, let's open this up. I've also wiped the shelves, like all of the pieces, just to make sure that there wasn't any more dust on them, and I shook off the dust off of this thing. So hopefully it will go well, and if you've done this like 20,000 times and you're watching me right now and you're just like, oh my gosh, what is she doing, please don't be too mean in the comments. But yeah, my goal for today would be to do like half of the work, but honestly, if I only stain like all of the 12 shelves that I have over there, it would already be a good accomplishment. Like, I can do those tomorrow morning and then finish the shelves in the afternoon when they've had the time to dry. Okay, Gonna pour this thing in here. Oh, it is very liquidy. Okay, I've been warned about this. Okay, I'm not gonna put too much of it in. I put like a third of the can in. Maybe that's too much, I don't know. We'll see. Okay, gloves are on. Gonna put some music on and then we're going to stain. And let's hope that I also don't put any anywhere else than on the shelves. Okay, let's do this. Okay, so good progress has been made, and that did not even take me like an hour, so that's good. I feel like you can definitely tell that some of them are like better than the others. Do not judge me on the first ones that I did on camera because they were absolutely terrible. I feel like I got better. I slowly got better as I went along. Yeah, like some of these look really good. These two are the first two that I did and they're not the greatest. They're a little bit streaky. So, you know, they're probably gonna be like at the bottom of the shelf so nobody can tell. This is the state that the gloves are in right now. So I think I'm gonna have to sacrifice my kitchen gloves because these did not survive this round. My fingers are so sticky. Like, can you see that? Oh, it's disgusting. Anyway, who knew stain was so sticky? But yeah, they look great. So far, I think I'm satisfied with the way that the color is looking right now. Like, I wouldn't do a second coat, but it will depend on how it looks when it's dry. I think I have to leave it to dry for at least like 6 hours or something like that. But yeah, you can definitely tell the difference between like this and this. Well, not this, these are not great, but this, like, that's a big difference. Yeah, I'm going to let this dry, then I'm going to decide if I do a second coat, and then I will see you again once everything is stained. Hello everybody, please do not mind my hair. I need to share my frustration with all of you. My apartment is a mess. It is impossible to live in here right now, and I am so ready for this to be over. I am never doing this again. But anyway, let's share an update. Let's be a little bit more positive because I am still making progress. So after I finished the first coat of stain, I realized that like some of it was a little bit patchy. By the way, I'm so sorry if you can hear the road outside, but I need to keep the windows open because otherwise I'm going to burn even more of my brain cells that I've already burned the other day because I did not open the windows. But anyway, so this is the situation right now. I have a second coat of stain on all of the planks that are going to become the shelves of the bookshelves. There are around like 9 around here, I think. And then in the corridor, we have one here. We have 2 there. This is my old bookshelf that I need to put on the side of the road so that it can go into the trash. And then here I have my chair because I can barely use my desk over there. So my chair is here with the other bookshelf. Hello. So as you can imagine, like, this is a small apartment. Literally the only place where I can sit right now is my bed. And my desk if I move this thing on the ground as far enough away, but I can't work on the actual shelves themselves because this is taking too much room and I can't stack them. So, keep in mind that this is the only room of my entire apartment besides my kitchen. My apartment has 2 rooms and one of them right now is completely cluttered and covered by everything and I am losing my mind. Honestly, like this is going to take so much longer than I thought and I'm going to have to make my peace with living into this situation right now for at least the next week. Like we're Monday and I'm gonna have to live through that for the entire week and then potentially the weekend if I can't finish staining everything at night after work. So yeah, I feel like most people who do these kind of projects, they have like a house, they have a basement or a garage or whatever. I'm just doing this in the middle of my living room. So yeah. At least this is a motivation for me to just keep on working on it because I want it to be out of the way as soon as possible. But you know, this is part of the process, so I wanted to share it with all of you, share my frustration, vent a little bit. I hope you don't mind. And at least, so far, I like the color. At least I think it's going to look cute, you know? And this morning I sanded everything before doing the second coat of stain and it looked much prettier already. So I think there's hope. I think I'm going to actually enjoy these bookshelves that I've spent the last 3 days on. That would be nice. Stay tuned to find out. Hello, everybody. So I told you last time that I would update you once we started to put the shelves together and it has started. So my parents are actually going to come over to help me put them all together. So I'm not actually going to film the entire process because my parents don't want to be filmed, but I've started putting some shelves in the shelves. So here we are. As always, my living room is chaos, but as you can see, I guess, I've put the top shelf over there and here's the bottom shelf of the first part. So there we go. The second part is over there. So that's the beginning. Then we need to put the little metal thing that goes like across so that it's stable. And then we can attach this one to this one with the actual shelves themselves. So yeah, that is the beginning. So the next thing that you're going to see is actually the shelves completed in 2 seconds. Enjoy! Hello everybody, it is the next day. Excuse once again the sounds of the washing machine if you can hear them in the background, but are you ready for the grand bookshelves reveal? Let's do this. Look at them! They are so tall! Oh my god! There they are in all their glory, finally done. Finally up. I've never had bookshelves that were this tall. I have so much room. It's crazy. And now I can start putting books in them. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Anyway, I think they look great. And now let's talk some plans for the books reorganization. So I already have a couple of ideas about where I want to put certain books. Obviously, I need one shelf for all of my Six of Crows editions and all of my other Leigh Bardugo books. I need my pastel shelf, which is what I call my shelf that is filled with like contemporaries and romance books. I also want to display my Jane Austen books better because they used to be on top of the other bookshelves, but you could barely see them in all of my videos. So I want to put them in a place where they're going to be more visible now. I also need a shelf for my other favorite fantasy series and a shelf for nonfiction. So yeah, we're just gonna get into this. I'm very, very excited to start organizing. So basically, I think that the plan for now is to put the Six of Crows books there, the Jane Austen there, the pastel shelf there, the other favorite fantasy books there, and then down there maybe nonfiction or maybe like V. Schwab. I also have like a lot of French books that I think I'm gonna put at the bottom just because they're not as pretty. And maybe this could be nonfiction and this could be like something else, I don't know. And I think that because these two shelves are so high, like I literally can barely reach them. I'm gonna leave them mostly empty for now, maybe put up some plants or something, and then I can put books that I like don't reach for as often up there. But yeah, we'll see how that goes. So let's begin. Thank you. Okay, so this is rather interesting. oh no. So as you can tell, like my Six of Crows shelf is obviously already up. This was the most important part. Then I have my Jane Austen shelf here. And the thing is, I'm actually considering like collecting all of these editions. So I think I'm going to have them like there or there. Like I might move things around, but in the meantime I think I'm gonna leave it like that because I have a very very cute little mug that I got in Portugal that I'm going to put on top of this, and I think that's gonna be like adorable. Anyway, this is the pastel shelf that I was talking about. It pretty much all of the books are there. I just need to like organize them and stuff. These are all of my Samantha Shannon and V.E. Schwab books. I think I'm gonna put them there. I'm not 100% sure. Then this is going to be like mostly nonfiction. Then I have this shelf, which is completely empty, so that's good. Then I have this shelf, which is going to be like more fantasy series. And then I have this shelf, which was supposed to be like my favorite fantasy series. But I'm not sure that they're all going to fit on there because I just kept on adding piles of books to this one. But the thing is, now it's getting pretty full already. I still have all of these books to fit somewhere. So I don't know. I don't know how that's going to work, but we're gonna make it work, okay? I feel like I said earlier, like, wow, I have so much room, and now I'm not too sure anymore, but they already look so good. It's gonna look so good, I'm so excited. Okay, let's keep on going. Okay, so this is what we're working with so far. Not too bad. I put all of my J.R.R. Tolkien books up there so they can have their own little like Lord of the Rings moment at the top of the bookshelf. Because I didn't know where to put them otherwise. I have this big hole right there in the pastel shelf that I need to fix. I'm thinking, oh, maybe I could put the Jane Austen there. But I really want the Jane Austen to have their moment. Who knows? Anyway, I'll figure it out. So I have this shelf, which is completely empty. I put all of my Louise Penny down there because there's so many of them. I knew they needed their own entire shelf. Then this is my kind of like nonfiction and French books shelves. It's basically like all of my nonfiction books, and I've just sprinkled like the French books where they fit. And I obviously had to prop out the Anthropocene Reviewed because it deserves its moment. It's like my favorite book of the year. But now what I'm left with, this is my on hold pile, so do not give it any attention, but these are the books that I'm left with. So I have a few like historical fiction, one or two fantasy books, my Truly Devious series, and like these are all of the books that every single time I reorganize my bookshelves, they all stick out like a sore thumb. Like I love them, but I never know where to put them. And then I also have down here like Still Life and this is such a tiny little pile. Anyway, Still Life and my Daisy Jones and the Six copy, and also like another historical fiction book. So I'm going to try to put them there and make them look pretty. Let's attempt this. Okay, so this is what we're working with so far. Do you see what I mean? Like, they don't really work together, but they also don't work anywhere else. I mean, some of these would probably actually fit on the pastel shelf. So maybe I should just put them up there. Let's see what it looks like if I put them up there. I'm mainly like focusing this shelf for like romance and queer fiction and stuff, but maybe some of these will look better up there. Just color scheme wise. So I'm gonna try that out. Okay, my camera battery is about to die, but I think I like this. I'm going to leave it like this for now. I'm gonna finish up the rest of the shelf and then I'll come back to you once I'm completely done. Okay, so it has been like 2 hours since the last time we spoke. I took a break, I had a little lunch, and now I think I might be done. But there are a couple of problems that we need to address. So I actually ended up switching the pastel shelf with the Jane Austen shelf because I felt like it was weird that these three shelves were like, well, this one's empty, this one's almost empty, and this one, because the Jane Austen books and the plant were not taking up the entire space, it was like just not balanced with the rest of it. So I ended up switching these two, and I think also it's gonna look better in my background for my videos if it looks like this. Now, the thing I need to address is the fact that I am missing two books on this shelf right now, and it's already super full. So I'm probably gonna have to tweak it a little bit because I'm missing Book Lovers by Emily Henry that my friend is actually going to bring back to me in like a couple of minutes. I'm also going to have volume 3 of Lore Olympus that needs to go in there, so it's not gonna fit. There's also the Heartstopper yearbook, which is coming out. I'm thinking about getting the collector's edition of Red, White, and Royal Blue. So, you know, I'm gonna have to remove some books from this shelf for sure in the very, very near future, but that is a problem for future me. Present me is just going to appreciate the fact that I think that for now, I'm done. So let's wrap up this entire thing. All right, hi, so it's me again. Here we are, a week later, the transformation is complete, and I am definitely very happy with how this bookshelf turned out. Let me know down below in the comments what you think of it. I really, really hope that you like it too. And now I think I am going to end this video with some aesthetic shots and a kind of like little bookshelf tour. So I hope that you enjoyed this. I hope that you enjoyed seeing the entire process throughout this video. And if you did, please don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!